Kickstarter community is so supportive and welcoming, and there are people out there who have dedicated a lot of time and energy to teaching you how to do an effective Kickstarter. So like Jamie Stegmaier, yes, yeah. Jamie Stegmaier over at Stonemaier Games, in addition to being a brilliant game designer, is like the guru of all of Kickstarter.
Literally wrote a book on it, and I'm
wrote the book.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah. And it's not just do your research. It's do your research and then listen to the advice that it's given. Don't think, oh, my project is different in a special snowflake and I don't have to listen to this advice. Listen to what they tell you to do.
Yeah. So Jamie Stegmaier's blog and then James Matthey as well have wonderful blogs that literally any question you might have, they have multiple blog posts. Like, how do you do worldwide shipping, you know, and have your factory send pallets of your games all over the world for the fulfillment centers, and there's just so many logistics.
That's very...
And they walk you through it.
It is a great calling card.
Yes.
So it is what has launched so much more. And I think that that's a way to think about it. It's about getting your work out into the world, and hopefully making like a name for yourself and building your brand, exactly.
Yeah.
You know, get reviews. That would be, I think, the next big tip.
Yeah.
Because if you are on Kickstarter, people are like wondering, how are you gonna be able to manufacture this? Is it any good, even if you manage to manufacture this? And James Matthey is the one who has a list of all the reviewers who will review Kickstarters and will review for free. I don't think you should pay for reviews. I think that that is not a good
but
idea.
But on his list, there are also people who charge for reviews.
Yeah.
So you can choose and see what's right for you.
And so then you can, you know, you need to give yourself enough lead time that you can get those reviews in and get those reviews onto your Kickstarter. So when people are looking at it, they know that they're not buying something that could be terrible, that maybe you haven't even started designing the puzzles, or maybe you have, you know, you have no idea where you're gonna get the components. At the very least, if you're sending out prototypes and people are reviewing it, you can make it by hand.
I'd say the next step after the reviewers is PR. Like, make sure you shouldn't launch and then, and I think a lot of people do, they launch and then they send it out to the bloggers and the vloggers and the, you know, news outlets and whatever and say, hey, I have a Kickstarter going on now. And it's like, by the time you get them to actually spend their time and review, your Kickstarter is gonna be over. So before you launch, send them all, you know, we had a press release. Another tip someone gave me was have a Dropbox with your press release. So that'll have like a little blurb about you, photos of the product, photos of you, and then send it to them in a link because they don't want to get an email with a bunch of sketchy attachments that they probably don't want to open.
Right.
Send them a link to a Dropbox and tell them, you know, briefly about it. And I would also say another tip, when reaching out to all of these reviewers, bloggers, media, everyone, personalize it because they are getting so many emails, especially if they're a popular reviewer. So tell them specifically, be like, I saw that you loved this game and I saw that you loved this game. My game does this and this in a similar way and then adds this, which is different. So I think you'll really enjoy it. And if they feel like you took the time to actually see their stuff, they're gonna be far more likely to want to support you and help you as opposed to if they get like a form letter.
Your Kickstarter page, first of all, make it pretty, but also just look at the other Kickstarters that are similar to your product that have succeeded.
Mm-hmm.
And see, okay, they all have pretty banners. Their video is sort of like this, you know, either it's computer graphics or it has interviews in it or it's about 3 minutes. Don't do like a 10-minute Kickstarter video.
Don't do a video over 3 minutes. Most people will only watch for two, but don't go over three. Be on Kickstarter backing projects. Like, you don't have to back the $1,000 projects, but you can back any project for $1 and you will get all of the updates for that project. And you can see how are they communicating with their backers? What are their stretch goals? What's getting people excited? You know, I think one of the best compliments that we got was that, you know, people just thought our level of communication was so excellent. And we really took it as like, you guys are strangers who have given us money because you believe this product is gonna be great. Like, that means the world to us. So of course we are gonna keep you posted every step of the way because as a backer, you're what made this happen. Like, we could not have done this without our backers. So just having that level of appreciation that like, this person didn't have to give you money. They don't know you. Right. Like, you owe them clear communication and a great product.
If you're replying to every person, and you should reply to every person that backs, then they will tell their friends about it. That gets you more backers, but it also gets you in communication with your backers, and they are important, and they have important things to say to you.
Yeah.
So think about, when are you launching?
Oh, yeah.
Don't launch in, you know, November, December. Everyone's spending their money on Christmas gifts. They're not spending their money on Christmas gifts that are gonna come in 2 years. They're spending their money on Christmas gifts that they can get right then.
Right.
So, you know, we launched in February. February was a great time to launch. People have their they then have their Christmas gifts and Christmas bonuses. They are, you know, back in the holiday and they're just, you know, hitting around on their computer.
When are people on their computers floating around Kickstarter? Not on a Saturday. Like, they're on there. We launched on a Tuesday morning. Like, that way you have everyone all week at work who's getting a little distracted. They're able to check it out. Saturday and Sunday, people are out with their friends, they're out with their family, they're not on their computers. Don't launch on the Saturday or Sunday.
Right, and Monday, they're taking care of everything they didn't do the week before. They're, you know, cleaning out their inbox.
Right.
Don't do Monday. You don't want to do Friday either, because Friday they're getting ready for the weekend.
Right. Yeah.
So, you know, like a Tuesday, Wednesday is really, I think, ideal.
Yeah.
And you want to launch first thing East Coast time. First thing when you launch is you should send an email concurrently to everybody in your address book. Doesn't matter whether you actually know them or not. I sent to a lot of people I didn't know. It's the only email I sent that they ever got from me, but you know, I happen to have their email from like a past year. And it asked people to back, but it asked if they would just back for a dollar. Because Kickstarter ranks you higher if you have more backers. So for all of our friends who weren't necessarily gonna buy the game, you know, a lot of our friends did, but we just said, look, if you can just back for a dollar, and most people will back for a dollar.
It's a much easier ask to say, just can you give $1 to support this project? That's all we want from you. And then, hey, if the project looks great and interesting to you, wonderful. We'd love it if you bought the full game. But like, it's much easier to ask people for a dollar than it is to ask them for $20, $45 or whatever your project.
Oh, some advice we got from the creator of Cards Against Humanity, who, you know, very kindly responded and gave us some advice, was don't do a billion bonuses.
Yes.
And we were gonna do t-shirts, and I can't imagine. It would have been such a nightmare. Yeah. That was like, it would have been terrible if you think about having to go through everybody's size and make sure they get the right shirt. It would have been the worst thing ever.
Yeah.
He said, you know, just keep it simple. And I think that that really works, particularly for games, where you're essentially just pre-buying a product.
Yeah, right.
You know, so the dollar, what, got you access to our party planner.
Yeah.
And then it was the game.
That's it. Because it's easy to think like, oh, but if we had t-shirts, we'd make a little extra money and blah, blah, blah. But the headache of having to deal with creating those, getting them out to the right people, like shipping,
nightmare.
Manufacturing, shipping, nightmares.
Yeah.
So like, if as much as you can make those things simple and easy for yourself, go for it. If as much as you can, try to make your content shareable. So like, our video, we're lucky enough to live in LA, so we had a friend who'd been on The Guild, which was a super popular web series.
Yes.
He invited his friend who had been on The Guild, and we had them in our Kickstarter video. So that was a great way for people to be like, oh my gosh,
they love it.
But you know, we've seen other people who did Kickstarters where it was just a super funny video, like anything you can do where it's not just like, buy the product, but it's actually something people are gonna wanna tell their friends about and share, try to do that in your video. Yeah.